हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज आस मोहम्मद खान एंड आई वेलकम यू विद टुडे सेगमेंट स्टूडेंट। टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग ए न्यू चैप्टर, चैप्टर 9, एंड इट इज रिलेटेड टू हेरिडिटी एंड इवोल्यूशन। मेनी टाइम स्टूडेंट यू लिसन फ्रॉम समवन एंड यू आल्सो डिस्कस विद ईच अदर दैट योर नोज इज लाइक योर फादर एंड माई नोज इज माई लुक लाइक माई मदर एंड दिस टाइप ऑफ डिस्कशन यू डू। दिस डिस्कशन that you have with each other, it is related to the traits that we have from our parents. And these traits or the characters that we have from our parents are known as hereditary characters. And these hereditary characters are passed generation after generation. So in this chapter, we will discuss about the hereditary traits or the characters, how are they passed from one generation to the next generation. So the transmission of the traits from one generation, the transmission of traits, the transmission of the traits from one generation to the next generation is known as heredity. And the traits that are passed from one generation to the next generation are known as inherited traits. And student, the gradual developments in a living organism, generation after generation, is known as evolution. And the branch of science that deals with the heredity and the evolution, or the branch of science in which we study about the transmission of the traits from one generation to the next generation, and we also study about the gradual developments that takes place in the new living organisms, though that branch of the science is known as genetics. And student, in the genetics, the chromosomes or the genes plays very, very important role. With the help of that, the traits move from one generation to the next generation. Now, what are the genes? Genes are the segment of DNA that are found on the chromosome. And what are they, student? They are hereditary units from which the characters or the traits move from one generation to the next generation. So in this chapter, we will discuss about the heredity and the evolution, student. Many times you observe your friend's earlobes, this. And in the earlobes, you will find the free earlobes and the attached earlobes. Some students have the free earlobes and some have the attached earlobes. So those earlobes are also the hereditary characters or inherited traits that they have from their parents or grandparents or foreground-grandparents. These traits are also come in the category of hereditary traits. And the student, there are some traits we acquire from the environment, and those traits or the characters are known as acquired trait. Like now you are doing the study, you write, you learn. So the trait that you acquire from the environment in the form of writing, in the form of wrestling, in the form of doing exercise, yoga, all these traits are known as acquired traits that you acquire from the environment. Like the riding of the bicycle also is an acquired trait. But the traits that you get from your parents are known as inherited traits, student. Like your color of skin, color of eyes, color of hair, your nose shape, your style of earlobes, all these traits are known as inherited traits. So there are the student, how many type of traits? Two types, hereditary traits and acquired traits. Now we come on the variation student, variations. Variations means student the differences in an individual from its parent. Like we are not completely similar to our parents. There are some variations are found in our body. And these variations are known as germinal variations because we get them from the germ cells, means it may be sperm and ovum, and when the sperm and ovum fused with each other, then at that time there are some variations come due to the error in DNA copying. That variation is known as germinal variation, and from which our color of skin may be changed from our parents, our style of hair may be changed from our parents, and that variation is known as, or that difference is known as germinal variation student. So due to the variations, we can easily diagnose or easily know about the identity of the person, and we can easily distinguish the two different person because there are many dissimilarities are also found. And as you know that the dissimilarities or the variation plays very important role. With the help of that, we can easily recognize the two different person. Now we come on the next variation. That variation we have from the environment, and that variation is known as student somatic variations. What we call that? Somatic variation. Somatic variation we have due to the environment. Like many times when we ride the bicycle and we learn it, then the riding of the bicycle is our which type of variation student? It is somatic variation that we acquire from the environment. But our parents don't know about the riding of the bicycle, but we know. It means we are varied from our parents in the case of riding of the bicycle. Like this, if our parents are farmer and they don't know the ABC and they don't know the writing, or that how do we write. So the variations that we have in the form of writing, that variation is known as somatic variation. So the germinal variation, there are the two variation, germinal variation and the somatic variation. Germinal variations come from the germ cells from the parents, and somatic variations come from the environment student. And both the variations are beneficial for the new individual or an individual. So it is about the variation, traits, heredity and evolution introduction student. Now in our next segment, we will discuss this topic in detail. Thank you very much and have a nice day.